Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to do a brief video here on the margin of error. When we compute the sample proportion, which is p hat, from sample data, to estimate the population proportion, which is just p, the difference between those two values represents an error. The maximum likely amount of the error is called the margin of error, which we just use a capital E for that. And it can be found by using the formula below. We have E equals Z subscript alpha over 2, which is the critical value that we find depending upon what our confidence level is. And then we have the square root of p hat times q hat. Remember, q hat is just 1 minus p hat. So p hat is a proportion. Let's say it's 20% or 0.2, then q hat would be 0.8. And then all over n, which is the number in our sample size. So that's the basic formula. It's not very complicated. The square root part of value is the actually estimated standard deviation for the sample proportion, but that's not really that important to remember. But a confidence interval used to estimate the population proportion is found by this. We take the sample proportion and we subtract the margin of error on one end, and we add the margin error to it on the other end. So let's say we had a sample proportion of 0.2 and we had a margin of error of 0.05. We would then be subtracting 0.05 down here and adding 0.05 here. And our proportion, you see how that does not have a hat on it because that's our population proportion. What we're saying is our proportion, the value for that lies somewhere in between these two values. You subtract from the lower end and you add to the upper end to get that. And you use your sample proportion to start off with. So example here, if you knew that the population proportion was 0.35 and the margin of error was 0.1034, then the confidence interval would look like this. You would take 0.35 at the beginning and subtract that margin of error. And at the end, you would take again that population or sample proportion and add the margin of error. And when you complete that addition or subtraction, you get 0.247, and on the other end, you get 0.363. And what that's saying is that our proportion for the population falls within those two values. That's our interval that we think it is. And if you've had some algebra in the past, you might remember that intervals can be written as, it looks like almost like an ordered pair, right? Where we say we're including that we have 0.247 on one end, and we have 0.363 on the other end. So this is one way to write an interval. This is one way to write an interval. But the other way to write a margin of error statement is to write the proportion and then say plus or minus this value. So those are three different ways that you might be asked to write those. And any one of those is okay. All right, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time. I'm making a lot of new statistics videos, so if you're interested in seeing those as they come out, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks. Have a great day.